Hey there, Michael Church with CrawlspaceNinja.com, and today I'm going to share with you how to test for mold in your home. So stay tuned for this information. Okay, so people call us up all the time telling us that they think they have mold in their house, but they're not sure. So there's a bunch of different ways you can do testing for mold. You can do what's called air sampling, which means you have to spend about $400 on an air sample test kit, and you have to pull air through these air cartridges and all that kind of stuff. That's not really a DIY way of testing for mold. Normally that would be if you're going to hire a mold inspector to come out and test for mold. They would use something like that. But if you just want to know for sure whether you need to test for mold, there's a couple of test kits available at Home Depot, and I'll put a link down below for that. The Home Depot kits, you can add the lab fee to it for an extra cost, but all it is a petri dish you're going to grow in your house, and you're going to create more mold in your house, and then you're going to look at it and be like, oh wow, that's a lot of mold. You have no idea what it is. You don't, it's all these funky colors. You have no idea what it is. But then you can say, oh wow, there's a lot. I want to send it off to the lab. And then you pay like an extra $40 to do that. So what we offer is we offer an actual DIY mold test. And we got two ways to do it. One is with a sterile swab or a tape lift. To be quite honest with you, the tape lift is a little easier because it's a little harder to mess up. The swab, you want to basically swab a 1-inch area. So let's say that you got drywall that's got some weird funky colors growing on it, and you want to see what kind of mold it is. You take the swab out and you just like rub it on there and you put it back in. I'm going to show you that here in just a second. The tape lift is this right here though. This is a tape lift mold test kit. So we got both of these options available on our DIY page. So first let's talk about the tape lift. Okay, so this is a tape lift. It'll come in this little hard case right here. If you order multiples, you want to make sure that you take a Sharpie or some kind of permanent marker and mark on there where you took the sample, because you're going to have to fill out a custody sheet that identifies where you sampled, and that way when you get the report back, you'll know exactly what samples are. Now, if you're only doing one, it's not that crucial, but a lot of people will do multiples, okay? All of those instructions are going to be in the DIY packet that you're going to get. But all you have to do is you just kind of pop this thing open like this, okay? And you just pull it out, and it's got a cool little piece of tape. It's a two-sided piece of tape right there. And then you take this and you just, if this is the drywall, you just like put it on the drywall, just like that, lift it off, and then put it back in here, seal it up, make sure it's labeled, stick it in the plastic bag that's included with the DIY kit. So that's how you would do a tape lift, which is the hardest one to mess up, okay? That's the one. The second sample that we offer on our DIY page is the sterile swab. So what you're gonna do is open up the little packet, and it's got this cool little sterile swab in it. These are used by medical professionals and all different people, but basically you want to open it up right here, pull that apart, and I just kind of like leave it like that so that way I can have my hand on it without touching the swab itself, okay? Because this is the swab right here. This is what you're going to put the swab in whenever you're done. So you're going to pull that out. See, my hands never touch it. Then you're gonna, let's say this is a drywall, you're gonna do a 1-inch, just like that, back and forth, okay? Don't roll it, you don't have to roll it, just like that. Then pull the lid off of the case, put the sterile swab in there, seal it. Now you're ready to rock and roll. You can throw all this away. So that goes into the baggie, into the envelope. Make sure you fill out the custody sheet if you're doing more than one swab. Even if you're doing one swab, I would probably put, you know, like bedroom or kitchen or something like that on here, or inside of HVAC ducts. Those are some of the areas that you can test. Put that in the mailer, send it off to the Assured Bio Labs, and they'll email you the results. A couple places that you might want to consider testing. Obviously an air sample will do a room, so it's kind of hard to do a room. I would do maybe down around the baseboards on a vent, like the register coming out of the heating and air unit. You can also do the return air grill because there's a lot of dust there. Around the toilet and the bathroom. Make sure that it's dry in the bathroom, like it's not really humid. Like don't do one right after you showered or something like that. You can go in the crawl space and do the joists or the subfloor. A lot of times people are concerned about their attic. If they may be thinking they had a roof leak, you can go up and do one of the trusses of the attic, under the sink, under the bathroom sink. So those are some of the areas you can test to see what kind of environment you've got. Remember, all homes have mold, okay? And some homes are higher and some homes are lower and some homes are off the chart with mold. One of the first indicators that you might have a mold problem is that you smell a musty smell. So if you feel like you've got an issue with mold, be sure to check out our DIY page down below. We're gonna put a link to both of those kits on that page. And also while you're down there, why not fill out the information to get that crawl space DIY guide that I mentioned before. So my name is Michael Church with crawlspaceninja.com, and I appreciate you watching us, and I hope you like this video down below, and make it a happy and blessed day. Thanks for watching.